So the last time we saw each other was on a plane.
That's right, going to Los Angeles.
So when I got on that plane, I was really tired and a little bit bummed because I'd been flying a lot, and it kind of brightened my day when I saw you.
Oh, I have that effect on people, you know? I don't know how. It's just no, but I mean, I'm tired today. I just flew from PEI to here, and I didn't get any sleep last night, but so we're even, you know? But you brightened my day today, so, you know? Yeah, because you were going to LA for work too, or no?
Yeah.
That's nice. I'm interviewing Matt because his life's way more interesting than mine.
That's not true.
Yeah.
Well, here's what I want to know, because I wanted to ask you on the plane, but, you know, there's people around.
Yeah.
What's going on in L.A.? You got a new record already done?
Just finished it, yeah. I was on my, I think when I saw you, it was on my second trip back, you know. And, yeah, it's coming out in February, so I'm just in the waiting mode now, you know, and worrying, you know, before it comes out, you are, oh, this is going to be the one everyone hates or something, but... it's called Carousel One, actually, which is the baggage carousel where our bags come out in L.A. when you fly Toronto to L.A. So,
did you already have the name, or did you get trip?
I had a bunch of names, and then I was sitting there, like, because I had to fly down a few times, and here I am at Carousel One again, and I just, and also my last two records were done in L.A. as well, so it just sort of became, you know, that's just stuck in my mind. You know? I think it's a good title anyway.
So did you come up with a name that day we saw each other?
Yeah, I think so, because that was like my second time, And I just said, because I had a bunch of names and I kept bouncing them off people, oh, that's not good or whatever.
Right.
And that one, I mentioned it to Jim, the producer, and right away he said, oh, I like that one, you know, so.
So who did you work with this time? Jim who?
Jim Scott, who, he's been, you know, he did a lot of, worked with Tom Petty a lot and Will Wilco and the Jayhawks. And, you know, he's been around quite, you know, I guess he's in his early 60s or something.
Yeah.
But just incredible experience. I mean, he just really knows what he's doing, you know.
Yeah.
And I'm not a producer, so I need to work with someone like who makes sure everything's being recorded right, you know.
I asked Joel Plaskett, this is a long time ago, but I this quote has stayed with me. Can I bring it into everything I do, whether it's film or television or music? I asked him how he felt. This was before he had the Nowhere With You song that was a hit for him.
Yeah.
And I said, how do you feel that, you know, people really dig your music, and you're selling out your shows across Canada, but radio and video stations really haven't embraced you, you know? How does that make you feel? And he said, you know what, when I hear what's on radio, when I see what's on video, and to know that I don't fit with that makes me feel pretty good.
Yeah, that's part of it too. I mean, I swim every day and they play the current hit station, and I don't see where I fit in there with all, I mean, that's, obviously, you know, every generation has its music that, you know, their stars and stuff. And I, you know, I'm a 50-year-old guy, so I can't expect to fit in there. And, I mean, but radio's never been my friend, so I've never, you know, missed it in a way, you know, because they've, except for the CBC, they've always been nice and stuff. But, you know, so whenever I get any radio at all, I just feel very lucky, or any television. I'm hoping, you know, I've done Conan, but I've never got Letterman, any of those shows. So I'm hoping maybe this next record, before he retires or something.
Right, right. Is turning 50 a big deal?
Well, yeah, I mean, I wasn't looking forward to it, not at all.
Really?
I just went to Greg Keeler's 60th birthday, though, so I've got 10 on him. But, the thing that was weird about it, because you're 50, and then all of a sudden, you know, my knees, I had some trouble with my knees already, which I never had before, and had, you know, and have to have all those examinations you get when you turn 50.
Right.
You know, all these things. And but then also on the plus side, I got an honorary doctorate, an honorary fellowship. You know, I don't. It's just crazy, right? And I did terrible in school, and they're giving me the diplomas. Sorry, I'm like a doctor. I'm a doctor now, doctor of laws, apparently, whatever that means.
Should I be calling you doctor?
Well, if you need me to perform surgery, you know.
I do have a little pain.
Yeah, I think I'm allowed to perform surgery now. But so, but it's just for me. It's just surreal and kind of embarrassing because, I had to go and make a speech, and there's all these students who've been working so hard and studying. I couldn't wait to get out of school. You know, I was like, I was looking out the window all the time and just dreaming of being a musician, you know.
Right.
So, but anyway, that's the thing that when I turned 50, all of a sudden all these prizes came my way and then all these ailments. And so, so I'm just trying to, I want to be healthy. I want my 50s to be kind of like Jim Cuddy. I want to be like, you know, you know, that guy, how does he do it, right? He's just, he's like
the genes, man. It's got to be in the genes.
All the time, right?
Know.
You know?
I know.
So, I want to kind of get my act together that way, you know. Hi, this is Ron Sexsmith, and you're watching JUNO TV.